Oh my God. Glory, bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. This technology, we have to learn it. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. This morning, devotion, dealing with the spirit of Saul. Hallelujah. Just coming from a powerful prayer from a woman of God. And I want to just share my devotion this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
You are Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. You do mighty things. You do glorious things. You're a faithful God. Awesome is your name. Sing with me one more time. You do mighty.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of the Most High God, King of Glory. We just worship you. We honor and we give you glory. Hallelujah. Good morning, Friday. We bless the name of Jesus. We bless the name of the Most High God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We bless the name of Jesus. We bless the name of the Lord. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Yes, it's been a while. I've been on and off my speaker. But just working on some projects. But we just bless the name of the Lord. Right now, I just cover myself, entire family, and also with the blood of Jesus. And the listener with the blood of Jesus and the fire of the Holy Ghost. We plead total blood coverage right now, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. I am up and I was just thinking in meditation with the Lord. And the Lord gave me some download that is like, oh God, it's so mind-blowing, but God is so faithful. He is faithful and he will help his own no matter what. Don't matter what the enemy try to throw at you. Don't matter what when the enemy think your ministry going to be downslide. Don't matter what the enemy might think of you. Always remember that Lucifer, he was one of the most orchestrated and good ministerial angel, praying angel that was thrown out of the heaven. So don't let anyone try to impress you. Look and find the heart of them. Find the heart of that person and know where their prior mode, where their prior model is set from. And don't let people are going to be fooling you in these last days. And you're going to fall to their schemes. You're going to fall to them their scams. Because I'm talking from experience. Anything I talk is what I myself experience. So I just want you to have your ears to the ground and your eyes open in this dispensation before the month is end. And you're ushering into now December as we are in November. Make your declaration. Stick with your declaration in the mighty name of Jesus. So this morning I want to deal with the spirit of Saul. When you're dealing with the spirit of Saul, and if you look in 1 Samuel 22, at your quiet time, you read it. and meditate. My meditation, and you just meditate on your meditation. But read the book of 1 Samuel 22, and I'm going to pick up from verse 11:23. But I love to read the whole content, but my time is unlimited on this broad podcast. So you go ahead. So we just cover again the environment with the blood of Jesus. And I pray that this message will change someone's life today in the mighty name of Jesus. And I read verse 11. The king sent to call Amalekah, the priest, the son of Atabub, and all his father's house, the priests that were in Nob, and they came all of them to the king. And Saul said, "Hear now, thou son of Atab." And he answered, "Here I am, my lord." And Saul said unto him, "Why have ye conspired against me, thou and the son of Jesse, in that thou hast given him bread and a sword, and hast inquired of God for him, that he should rise against me to lie in wait at this day?" We pause there. There are many people that lie in wait for your downfall. There are many people that will lie in wait for your downfall. There are many people that will set you up. But always look at a setup as a blessing, because no weapon of the wicked one that fashion against you shall ever be able to prosper in the mighty name of Jesus. And I read, "Then Ahithophel answered the king and said, And who is so faithful among all thy servants as David, which is the king's son-in-law, and goeth and at thy bidding, and is honorable in thine house? Did I then begin to inquire of God for him? Be it far from me, let not the king impute anything unto his servant, nor to all the house of my father. For thy servant knew nothing of all this. Less more, as the king said, thou shalt surely die, Amalekah, thou and all thy father's house. And the king said unto the footmen that stood about him, Turn and slay the priests of the Lord, because their hands also is with David, and because they knew when he fled, and did not shew him to me. But the servant of the king would not put forth their hand to fall upon the priests of the Lord. And the king said to Doeg, Turn thou and fall upon the priests. And Doeg the Edomite turned, and he fell upon the priest, and slew on that day 85 persons that did wear a linen ephod. And Nob, the city of the priest, smote he with the edge of the sword, both men, women, children, and suckling, oxen, horses, and sheep with the edge of the sword. And one of the son of Amalekah, the son of Atab, named Abitar, escaped and fled after David. And Abitar showed David that Saul had slain the Lord priest. And David said unto Abitar, I knew it that day when Doeg the Edomite was there, and they would surely tell Saul, I have occasioned the death of all the person of thy father house. Abide thou with me, fear not, for he that seeketh my life, seeketh thy life, but with me thou shalt be in safeguard. Dear beloved, sometimes you need to be with people that you are in safeguard. And some of the people that you think you are in safeguard with, those are the one that will slay you. Those are the one that will turn their back against you. So here is it. There is a spirit of Saul that is running rampant in and out of the church, on social media, in your life, in your household. And you have to be very, very careful, because that spirit is running rampant right now. Right now it is running rampant. So you have to slay your face to the altar and learn how to pray and pray for yourself in the mighty name of Jesus. Many people in the name of waiting to get even or payback an offender have destroyed their destiny helper. Evil as a way of boomerang on the wicked. As ashes go back to the person that blow or scatter it, in the story of King Saul of Israel, it really come to mind here at the present. With us this profound lesson this morning. Our lesson this morning is the account of how King Saul ordered and supervised the killing of all the priests in the land. Beginning with the priest Ahimelech, the son of Ethiop, in fact, on the order of Saul, Doeg the Edomite slew 85 priests, as well as men, women, children, suckling, oxen, ass, sheep, in Nob, the city of the priests. However, one of the sons of Amalek, called Abitar, escaped and ran to David for protection. It is obvious, saints, that Saul's action was filled by rage, envy, and evil determination to kill David. Let me pause here for a while. Do you know that people out there are determined to kill you and I? They are determined and set their mind to kill. But how can you kill who God have anointed to live? You are casting a boomerang on yourself. You are scattering the ashes back in your face. You cannot kill who God ordained and appointed to live. It won't work. What else would have moved him to kill the priest of the Lord? Why did he not stop to think of the consequence of his action before he took them? Saul paid dearly for this, this tasty act, and later in the future, a lot of people that is trying to kill you right now are trying to have ill will against you. Believe me, it will boomerang in the mighty name of Jesus. You stay close to the Most High God. You try to give honor where honor is due, and God will reward you and recompense you in due season in the mighty name of Jesus. Saul's life was full of many costly mistakes. Don't let your life full of costly mistakes. He had more an impulse than reason and seeking God for guidance. When he refused to wait for Samuel and transgressed the office of the priest by offering sacrifice, he incurred God wrath. A lot of you are offering sacrifice. A lot of you are offering sacrifice and incurring God wrath, and you don't even realize. And a lot of you realize, but you still want to do that because you believe that your covenant is so deep with God that you can get away with murdering me or murdering someone else, but it will not work. Here also he killed the priests of the Lord as if they were chicken, and further earned himself the wrath and judgment of God. A combination of these wrong choices and error made by God to reject Saul, and eventually also when Prophet Samuel died, Saul became helpless
because he had not really built a strong relationship with God, nor build a prayerful lifestyle. I am here today to tell somebody to build a prayerful lifestyle, to build a relationship with God, to build a true relationship with God. When you have a true relationship with God, the wicked of the wicked cannot defeat you in the mighty name of Jesus. The wicked of the wicked will not defeat you when you have a relationship with God. Because a lot of people have say they have a prayerful lifestyle, but who are they praying to? And who are they praying with? Know how to rend heaven for yourself in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will always send two. He will always send two. And learn how to rend heaven in the name of Jesus. One day, the host of the Philistine gathered against Saul at assault a battle. When he saw them, he was afraid. In 1 Samuel 28, 6, at your quiet time, read it. The Bible says that Saul inquired of the Lord, but the Lord answered him not, neither by dream nor by Urim, nor by prophet. It is terrible thing for God to abandon anyone. I pray that the Lord will never abandon me. I pray that the Lord will never leave or forsake me. I pray that the Lord will never abandon you, leave you or forsake you in the mighty name of Jesus. Again, Saul took an impulse and foolish decision. He told his servant to seek him a woman with a familiar spirit, so that they may inquire from her. God had warned sternly that his children should not consult anyone with familiar spirit, nigromancy, sorcerer, a wizard, witch, or warlock. The servant told Saul about the woman with a familiar spirit who lived at Endor. To the amazement of the medium, God intervened and made Samuel to appear, even though he was dead, to appear and speak to Saul. Then the same judgment he had passed to him from God. When Samuel was alive, he had earned God's rejection for falling to execute God's wrath on the Amalekite. Samuel added that by the next day, Saul and his children would die because God would give him to the Philistine. How many of you this Friday morning? Happy Friday, Shabbat, Shabbat Shalom. How many of you, God is waiting to hand over to your enemy to kill you because you are not taking heed? I pray you will be not one of them in the mighty name of Jesus. I am here to tell a beloved, if Saul had not made David his enemy and sought to kill him, he would have had an anointed helper to assist him in confronting and defeating the Philistine. But you know, when you make enemy with someone that is trying to help you, there is no help for you in sight. Because you make enemy with your helper. Don't try to make enemy with your helper in the mighty name of Jesus. Don't try to make enemy with your helper. Do not try to make enemy with your helper. I know I'm speaking to someone. I am on live chat. No one is not chatting and it is well. Don't try to make enemy with your helper. Do not try to make enemy with your helper. When God send you an anointed helper, don't turn your back to try to kill them, because you will be the one that will be in the gas chamber. Hallelujah. You will be the one that will be there. So I am here to tell somebody today, as I tell myself, if he had not killed all the priests of the Lord in Nob, they would have been there to inquire for him from the Lord. I want you to learn from Saul's mistake. Lean not unto your own understanding. In all your way, acknowledge the Lord and seek his guidance before you act. He will direct your path and your life will be a huge success story. Seek God earnestly. Seek him. Inquire of him. In the mighty name of Jesus. Don't be like Saul. Do not turn away your anointed helper, because you're going to need your anointed helper. I'm going to pray right now, and then I'm going to do another prayer. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. I am in the mighty name of Jesus. I decree and I declare this morning the mistake of the power that will not. That will not, no mistake will have the power that will turn me against my helper, because mistake of the power to turn you to someone better than you were before. Mistake of the power to turn you to someone better than before. Mistake will turn you, of the power to turn you to someone better than before. Don't let your mistake turn you bitter. Let your mistake turn you better. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray today that you will not fall from grace to grass. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I will not kill my destiny helper. I will not drive my destiny helper away in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of self-destruction, I reject you in the mighty name of Jesus. Every spirit of error that leads me to fall of destruction, I command you to die right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, my Lord and my God, give me the grace, the wisdom, and the power to make right choice in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus, I will not end my life disgracefully like King Saul. In the name of Jesus, Father, I'm asking you, O God, to intervene in my affair and save me from the agenda of the wicked. Save me from the agenda of Satan and his cohort. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I'm asking you to save me, to save my children, that we do not have to deal with the spirit of Saul. In the mighty name of Jesus. Marakadabo Shandarabahaya Rabo Satai. Leba Huntu Sodabo Shandarabahaya. Mekarabo Sandarabo Shaya Rabasei. Leyan Dosa Madarabo Shaya. Lord, I command the blessing from above. Lord, I command the blessing from above. In the mighty name of Jesus, the blessing of the Lord, I command it over my life, over the life of my children. In the mighty name of Jesus, let the blessing from above be my agenda, O God. In the mighty name of Jesus, let the blessing from above come up on me, O Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus. Reba haso todabo shaya rabai. Laba handarabo sandarabo shaya. Le kandusa matarabo shedabo shaya. Mandarabo sayarabo shaya. May the spirit of Saul will not locate me in the mighty name of Jesus. May the spirit of Saul not locate me or my children in the mighty name of Jesus. I reject the spirit of Saul in the mighty name of Jesus. I reject the spirit of Saul this morning in the name of Jesus. I will break the spirit of Saul. I reject it. I reject the spirit of Saul in the mighty name of Jesus. Rabba handaraba shaya rabo satai. Le mandorobo sandarabo shadabahaya. Le basandarabo shaya rabo sandarabai. He kodobo sandorobo shaya rabba. Le da basandarabo shaya rabasaya. Lord, let my covenant stay with you. In the mighty name of Jesus. The word covenant translates from the Hebrew word beret is used in the Bible, at which it binds two or more people together. Lord, bind me with you. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, bind me with you. I reject the spirit of Saul in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I'm asking you, God, that as my covenant between you and I becomes stronger, you are a God of covenant. You are a God of covenant. You are always watching over your covenant and me to perform it in the mighty name of Jesus. I reject the spirit of Saul. In the name of Jesus, I reject it, O God. I reject the spirit of Saul. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I'm asking, O God, to give me divine preservation. In the mighty name of Jesus, remove the spirit of Saul from around me, from around my children. In the mighty name of Jesus, you are the source of my help, O God. Let me not fall in the hands of Saul. Let me not fall in the hands of Saul. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, your covenant is with me. You're always watching over your covenant to perform it. Lord, as you made a covenant with Noah, as you made it with Abraham and David, to have an unbroken everlasting covenant with them, Lord, I'm asking you to have an unbroken covenant with me in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I'm asking you, O God, to do it for me, O God. Establish your covenant with me. Establish your covenant with me, God. Establish your covenant with me in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, the covenant that I made with you through the blood of the Lamb, Lord Jesus, this covenant is eternal and it's available for me in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I am asking, O God, to let not the enemy corrupt my original intention of my divine covenant with you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I reject the spirit of Saul. In the mighty name of Jesus. You know, a lot of us have a covenant, as I just pray, I'm going to pray again. A lot of us make covenant with the wrong people. We make covenant with the wrong people. We make covenant with the soul of man that deceitfully trapped us. You need to nullify and void that covenant in the mighty name of Jesus. You can make conscious evil covenant or unconscious evil covenant. The devil do this in order to achieve his threefold bid to kill and to steal and to destroy you. Whatever covenant you have made with the wrong people, I ask you in the name of God to reject it and ask God to forgive you in the mighty name of Jesus. Know that the children of God must be wary of the device of the devil so that you will not be trapped in evil covenant. In other words, it is very vital to form in a covenant. There is a powerful connection between the word covenant, whether it's silent or loud, whether it's verbal or it is written. This is very, very important. And believer must be very careful what he or she speak or discuss with your mouth. A lot of you discussing the wrong thing with your mouth. A lot of you are making demonic covenant. But I pray, oh God, anyone that try to make any covenant with me that is not of you, as I look at Genesis 9:12-17, I reject it in the mighty name of Jesus. I reject every evil covenant in the mighty name of Jesus. And know that my covenant will not break, nor will it alter the thing that has gone out of my lip. I made a covenant with you, Lord, and I will keep my covenant because you're a covenant keeping God. Roto Shatarabahaya. Russia to Sebunga the Bahai, Russia to the Bosanda the Bahai, Leba Sanda the Boshaya, Lama Handa the Boshaya. As I renew my covenant with you this morning, all past covenant with death shall be annulled over my life, over the life of my children. Every covenant with death, spiritual, physical, financial, it is null and void in the mighty name of Jesus. I break every covenant of demotion over my life in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus. Conscious and unconscious covenant of the enemy will not prevail over my life, the life of my children, the life of my ministry, in the mighty name of Jesus. Any covenant that I have made with death, I verbally null it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Any covenant that I have made with any familiar spirit in my life, I break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Covenant bringing food from any evil altar into my life, dry up now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every satanic covenant against my future, against my children, against my ministry, against my finance, against my health, I scatter you with the fire of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus. Fire of the Holy Ghost, break every evil covenant, every witchcraft covenant, every sorcerer covenant, every covenant that delayed my breakthrough, that delayed my ministry, I break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Rabandaba shikadabo sabahaya rabanduraboa, rebakotodaba seliandrabahaya, lemando sebatutabo shayarabaya, rebasedebo shayarabandarabaya, lebasandaraba sundurabo shabahaya, magadaba senderabo shay. Le basondorobo saya, le basandaraba saya, le basandaraba saya. The Lord said, this is the token of the covenant which I made between me and you and every living creature that is with you, your perpetual generation. I do set my bow in the cloud, and it shall be for a token of covenant between me and the earth, and it shall come to pass. I will bring a cloud over the earth shall bow and shall see that the cloud, and I will remember my covenant which I made between you and every living creature. Lord, every covenant that you made with me, Lord, let it come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it come to pass in the mighty name of Jesus, and the bow shall be in the cloud, and I will look up in it, and I remember the everlasting covenant, God and every living creature. Lord, I'm asking for my covenant, just as you made the covenant with Noah. This is the token of the covenant which you have established between me and the flesh upon this earth. I establish my covenant with you, God, and let it be not null, let it be not void. In the mighty name of Jesus, I break every evil covenant that is around me, every soul tie, every wrong covenant with anyone that is not of you. I break it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I break it in the name of Jesus. Lord, I come against every agent of defilement that want to defile my covenant. I destroy it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I'm asking you, oh God, every evil agent that want to defile my covenant, I break it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Any evil spirit that claiming ownership of my covenant in my life, I command you to scatter. I command you to burn and null and avoid it now in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Ghost fire, purge me this morning. Purge me completely, O God, and renew my covenant with you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I release myself from any sexual pollution, covenant that you have made. Lord, I release myself in the mighty name of Jesus. O God of Elijah, arise in every ancestral pollution that tried to defile my covenant. I break it in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I'm asking for divine visitation in the name of Jesus. Lord, remove every unholy covenant in the name of Jesus and bring me holy covenant. Ramandarabo sete de boshaya, lekadobo si andarabahandarabo shatai, makadosa mandarabo sharabasaya, yedebo si andarabahadarabo sai, rebandarabo shamandarabo sadabahaya, rabasete de boshaya rabandarabo, lebasandarabo shaya, Holy Ghost fire. Set me free from every evil covenant that is controlling my family line. Set me free from it. In the mighty name of Jesus, every power that is assigned to enforce every evil covenant, Lord, I ask you right now, O God, that it die by fire. In the mighty name of Jesus, by force and by fire, I release myself from every evil covenant. I release myself from every ancient and modern curse of covenant in my bloodline. I release myself from it in the mighty name of Jesus. My destiny come out of every evil covenant now in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil covenant that is holding me down, I break you, I break you, I break you to pieces in the mighty name of Jesus. I renounce all hidden soul tie and covenant in the mighty name of Jesus. I renounce it now. Every evil covenant of hardship, I break it right now with the Holy Ghost fire in the mighty name of Jesus. Ramandarabo Shaya, Lemandaraba Sandarabai, Reba Handarabo Satarabo Shaya, Leba Sandarabo Shaya, Lodabo Shaya Rabo Saya, Leba Kandarabo Shaya, Leba Sadaba Shaya. Any evil covenant, Lord, I cry to you for mercy. I break it now in the mighty name of Jesus. I break it now. In the mighty name of Jesus, every occultic covenant, I break you now. In the name of Jesus, I break you now. In the name of Jesus, every evil pattern, I break you now. In the mighty name of Jesus, Rabba Kadaboshaya, I break every evil covenant in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the Living God. Abraham lied, Isaac did too, Jacob lied and deceived his father, his son too lied concerning Joseph. Every evil pattern, I break you and I release the covenant of God, the covenant that the Lord made with Noah. I release it over my life. I release it over my children. I release it over my ministry. I release it over my finance. I release it over my health. In the mighty name of Jesus, my covenant will not break. My covenant will not alter. The covenant that I have with God will stand assured, steadfast. In the mighty name of Jesus, Reba Haya Nadabo, Ramandaraba Shaya, Leba Sandarabo Shaya, I decree and I declare that it shall stand in the mighty name of Jesus. It will not be broken. In the name of Jesus, I command every evil covenant to let me go, release me, and let me go in the mighty name of Jesus. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him will I trust. Surely He shall deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover me with His feather, and under His wing shall thou trust. His shoe shall be my shield and my buckler. I shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor that the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. Lord, my covenant will stand with you, because 1,000 shall fall at my side, and 10,000 at my right hand, but it shall not come near me. Only will I behold to see the reward of the wicked, because For thou hast made me the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Almost High my habitation. There shall no evil befall me, neither shall any plague come near my dwelling. For he shall give his angel charge over me, to keep me in all the ways. They shall bear me up in thy hand. Let thou dash thy foot against a stone. Yet I shall tread upon serpent, lion, adder, long lion, dragon, thou shalt trample under my feet, because he had set his love up on me. Therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high, because he know my name. He know my name is Dawn. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him and said, yes, Lord, I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation. My covenant is renewed with God. In the mighty name of Jesus, he is a covenant keeping God. He is a covenant keeping God. He is a covenant keeping God. And his covenant will not break. He will not break his covenant with me, because he's a covenant keeping God. My new covenant is made through the blood of the Lamb of the Lord Jesus Christ. My covenant is eternal. In the mighty name of Jesus, I stand on Psalms 91. I stand on John 3:16. Stand on Psalms 93, Romans 15:1-3, in the mighty name of Jesus. All my past covenant with death is annulled in the mighty name of Jesus. Hey, Kadarabashundarabuhaya. Labahandarabu Shatarabahayarabosa. Makado Shendirabu Shadabahaya. Rabba Shotorabo Sayarabo Sandarabo. Reba Satarabo Shandarabahaya. Makado Shatotorabo Shaya. Romandorabo Shatikodo Sabahaya. Ropa Tuze Bagaramo Shinda Zagari. Rasha Tuze Bahaya Rabo Sandarabai. Father, I just bless your name. I honor you, O God, because you're a good God. I honor you, O God, because you're a merciful God. I honor you, O God, because you're good. You're a good God all by yourself. Lord, I cover myself with the blood of Jesus. I cover myself with the fire of the Holy Ghost, that there shall be no backlash, no retaliation, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I'm asking you, God, to let my covenant stand with you, in the mighty name of Jesus. My covenant with you will not be shortened. My covenant with you will not be altered, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I ask you right now to let my covenant stand, in the mighty name of Jesus. Rabba Hanto Totorabo Shaya. Malaba Kurebo Sandarabo Shaya. Leyan Dusabato Rabo Shaya. Makadabo Sedebo Shandarabahaya. Ladaba Senderebo Shaya. Makadabo Shandarabo Sayarabo Shaya. Le Bando Semandarabo Shadabahaya. Reba Debo Sadabo Shaya Rabo Saya. Leba Senderebo Shaya. Father, we just bless your name. We honor you and we give you glory, because you're a God all by yourself. I bless your name, O God. I thank you, God, for making a covenant with me that will stand and shall stand. Every other covenant has been annulled. It has been canceled with the fire, the liquid fire of God. I thank you, O God, I cover myself with the blood of Jesus and the fire of the Holy Ghost, that there shall be no backlash or retaliation in the spirit. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. May the word of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight. Indeed, O Lord, you are my strength and my redeemer. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, that I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen, so shall it be. Thank you, Holy Father, we just bless your name. And I cover this page with the blood of Jesus and the fire, the liquid fire of God. Thank you, my Lord and my God. Glory and honor belong to you. And my covenant stand. My covenant with my children stand. And my covenant with you stand. Thank you, Abba Father.
Jesus' name I pray. Amen.